Hello again, I'm Dr. Kerr. Welcome to Asante Academy. Chinese herbal medicine, in our history, we do using some of the, you know, endangered species of animals or plants. That was sort of a historical fact. So we don't want to deny them. But nowadays, do we really use them? Or is the Chinese medicine full of all these tiger bones, bells, you know, bears, bells, all these things? No, I don't think this is a true reality. Because first of all, in terms sort of a government to control that, the Chinese government has already signed into the International Convention to preventing using those products. And also in public, people already know that this is very bad. So people should not use them. And as a doctor, Chinese medicine, I've been practicing almost 40 years Chinese medicine. I never use any of these endangered species anymore because I don't need them. Because so-called tiger bone, and you know, there's many other things can be used as a replacement. Why wouldn't you use tiger bone? But in fact, also they're very expensive too. So I can't sell people too expensive medicine. People don't want to buy. So in fact, this is not the true reality. You know, Chinese medicine all contains of these endangered species of animal. But is anybody using them? Yes, because there are some people always using these illegal things. Just like, you know, people in this country say you're allowed to using heroin or cocaine or marijuana, but there are some people do that. So, but that's only a very small proportion of the public. So same Chinese medicine. So as a whole, Chinese medicine, we are very aware of this endangered species of animals and the plants, and we completely condemn on those people who use them, and we fully support this protection of them.